party! Any other requests?
Flight of the Bumblebee.
Flight of the Bumblebee. I'm going to play it in 1 second. We'll be good. Any other requests? Which one? Old Town Road. Woo! I'd love to play it, but my horn doesn't know how to do a triple negative. Any other requests?
We will rock you.
Woo! Little Queen, we will rock you.
So, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to ask you all a question, and then I'm licensed, not in this state, but in others, to gauge your response according to the volume and duration of your response. That will determine scientifically what kind of show you want us to do for you right now, thus making this 1 o'clock mud show your show, which means if it's a crappy show, it's your fault. So here's the question. How's everyone doing? All right? Woo! Yes. All right, little soda. Show before.
Yeah. Woo! We have no taste.
People are sick, you know. How many of you have never seen the Mud Show? Oh, you're gonna be sick. Now, I couldn't help but notice as I look over the tops of your heads, as a lot of our material may fly, there are still a lot of people out there wandering around who are not as intelligent as we are. There are people out there right now who do not realize that the cultural extravaganza of the entire fair is about to take place. So I believe it is our civic duty to educate each and every one of those moron people out there. But I need your help. What I need everyone here to do, if you are mentally capable, I'm serious, if you don't think you can do what I'm about to ask, do not attempt it. But if you can, I would love it if you could raise your right hand above your head. Can you do that? Pretty good. I see a few people know their limitations. That's all right. Now, take that very same hand and place it gently, gently on your throat. Careful. Don't spill your beer. Now, with your other hand, and for those of you keeping score, that's your... Oh, it sounds like you're guessing. Okay, take that other hand and point directly at the mud pit while keeping your right hand on your throat. Well, we lost a few on that one. All right, now, on the count of three, I want you all to yell at the top of your lungs. And if you're wondering where that is, you should be holding on to them right now. I want you all to yell, "Oh my God, they're doing it." 1, 2, 3.
Oh my God, they're doing it.
Here comes Jerry Springer. Oh, more amazing. People turn to look. Ladies and gentlemen, we're about ready to begin, but we got a bit of a problem. If you look around, you'll notice there are shaded seats that are empty. We call these gaping gaps. And these gaping gaps during the show are a potential health hazard, because what happens is that all the people who come late, and by that, I am referring to the drunks who come from a pub right over there.
Okay, one's early.
The late drunks, though, they storm in, and they take those empty seats during the show. Not only will this upset your viewing and listening pleasure, but as these people pass in front of you, guess what they do? They fart. Oh, yeah, I see whole families go down. So I had to sit down, and I had to carefully analyze the situation. But eventually, I was able to rectify a solution. What we're going to do is play a very simple game that we like to call Squishy Butt. But it's not how you play at home. How we play here is I count to three. And then we all yell, "Squishy Butt," at which point in time, we are going to squish our very own butts. And if we're lucky, the butt of a loved one. And if we're real lucky, the butt of someone we don't even know. Towards the center of the auditorium, where you can see and hear better, if there's an empty seat in front of you, you will move forward. And this way, all the empty seats in the middle magically appear in the back. Fart bags are drawn there like maggots. They blow it out the rear, and none of us get hurt. You're welcome. Oh, in the back? You might want to come in and grab some of these empty seats. I'll tell you why. Because of the nature of our show, a lot of times we can't use Mr. Turkey Leg. And without Mr. Turkey Leg, sometimes our voices simply do not grow. So if you're having any, I suggest you, the art animal. This way. Oh, but he gets hurt. So here we go. Squishy bar on three. 1, 2, 3.
Squishy bar.
Move in, move forward, move in,
move
forward.
Shaded areas.
Squishy
bar.
We're
all
here. You're all
squishy.
Let's get it.
Come on,
come on,
announcement is for everyone. Save all the cars. I have to say this before all of our performances. Just bear with me. Although my partner and myself are highly trained, we are not actors. We are beggars. And I'm going to repeat that because sometimes that concept gets lost during the show. The two of us are beggars. So there will be a point in the show where we are contractually obligated to pass the hat. We say it now so we don't shock you later. I hear you. So, ladies and gentlemen, if you enjoyed the show, put a little something in the hat. If you didn't, that's okay. Just don't take anything out. But if you have no money to give, we want you to sit back and enjoy the entire show. With that being said, on the count of three, I need you all to cheer, applaud, whoop it up. Just bang the heads of your children together as if some form of wonderful entertainment were taking place. 1, 2, 3.
Ladies and gentlemen, give me an air.
M. Yeah, you.
You.
Yeah, D.
D.
What's that spell?
Mud.
What's that spell?
Mud.
I can't hear you.
Mud.
And what's mud spelled backwards?
Dumb.
Right you are. Welcome to a very dumb mud show. One which will rule that while good taste is timeless.
A good time is often
tasteless.
You've heard of theater in the round.
Well, this is theater in the
ground.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are
the Sturdy Beggars,
creators of
the original mud show.
The show we lovingly refer to as
the greatest show in earth.
Woo! Rock is mud show. Rock is mud show. Rock is mud show. Sturdy. I can't go on.
Why not?
This audience has no rhythm.
Oh. Hey, maybe that's how all these little kids got here.
People, we don't have time to explain all the jokes to the non-Catholics, all right? The truth of the matter is, Halfwit,
yes.
I was referring to a collective rhythm.
Huh?
I was on this side.
Yeah.
And it was obvious. Over here, everyone was clapping right, yeah. And everyone over there was clapping wrong. Am I right?
Yeah. Woo! God,
they were clapping like a bunch of blinking morons.
That is blinking.
For your information, we are not blinking. And secondly, for your information, everyone over here just happens to be the greatest side in the history of side. Yelling and screaming at the top of our lungs settles nothing.
Well, it does on Fox News.
Well, yeah, on Fox News. But we gotta settle this very natural conflict that you people brought with you so we can do the mud show in a civilized manner. Now, I don't know who started this. I don't really care. But we are gonna settle this very natural conflict. We're gonna do this with a chant-off.
A chant-off!
Yeah. Now, chant-off is the two rival groups.
Rivals!
Who are separated by hatred.
Hatred!
Separated by conflict.
Confliction!
Separated by opposing ideologies.
Bunch of idiots!
They all gather around an open cesspool.
Ooh, that sounds like Congress.
Pretty much. Now, instead of beating each other up, they learn a yell or a cheer or a
chant.
From the Latin word chant, meaning
to chant.
And whichever side is the loudest is then deemed the greatest side in the history of side. Just that us?
Woo!
People, don't blow your wad early.
No!
My ex-wife taught me that.
Yes! She taught me that, too.
Yeah, well, not just about everybody. No matter how loud both sides are, there's still going to be one side which isn't quite so loud. And there's no shame in that. But forevermore, they'll be affectionately known as the skanky losers. And as skanky losers, they're going to be forced to move, live, and breed in Oklahoma.
Yeah.
We got to win, damn it. I spent 2 weeks there one night.
I
noticed.
I'm sensing a little confusion in the
blue. You, sir, in the blue cap. Do you know what sign you're in? Okay, well, I had to ask.
Honestly, God, from up here, it looks like you go both ways.
I don't know why they're laughing. They must know you. Tell you what, I'll draw a line.
Shall be drawn. Starting back there.
I'm going to draw a line. It's going to go right through the mud pit. And then it's going to go right through the audience. Look out. I'm coming through. I am coming through. I am coming through. I'm coming through.
The the line.
What about the line?
It bisexualizes this woman.
I think the word you want is bisex.
What did I say?
I'm not sure, but man, is she popular now.
I got an idea.
Yeah?
Milady, stay right where you are. You're going to be a line of demarcation. From now on, you're not this side, you're not that side.
Madam, you're neither here nor there.
Neither yin nor yang.
Neither up nor down.
You are the middle.
Yes, and I hereby decree that everyone to this side, the lovely yet divided woman's right breast over this way, we will now be known as the beautiful people of Sparta!
Beautiful woman. From now on, we are going to be the great people of Troy. And I will be standing in the back watching but not participating. You're the woodlands. Now that we know who you are, it's time to learn who we are.
Who the heck are we?
Ladies and gentlemen of Sparta, this is your beggar. This is your champion. He's amazing, man. He's absolutely phenomenal. This guy over here, this guy right here, happens to be illiterate in 27 different languages. Please, give it up for Halfway to Henry.
Woo! I love you, my people. Well, so then, turn about his fair play. Troy, I would like to introduce you to your champion, a superman of mind and body. Possibly the greatest individual who has ever lived. I would like to introduce him, but he's not here.
Yeah, he's playing golf.
Instead, here's his next door neighbor,
down.
Billy VonBilly.
Woo! 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 Woo!
Yes. Cheer, why don't you?
Very well, let's spawn our cheer. A cheer that will strike fear into the hearts of the enemy.
Sounds
like this. Sparta! Sparta! Make the earth shake!
Woo!
I know what you're thinking. The woo at the end is silly. I agree. But it does strike fear into their hearts.
Not so much so fear is concerned.
As discussed.
3, 2, 1.
Sparta! Sparta! Make the earth shake!
Boo!
No wooing in the back. Don't be afraid to look stupid.
I'm sorry, did you do it? I couldn't hear you. Troy, we're the best side.
Woo!
We better be. We got the best chant. Goes like this.
Trojans, we will never break. Hunt.
Trojans.
1, 2, 3.
Trojans, we will never break. Woo!
Okay, sounded great, but I noticed all the guys in the woodlands were not hooting. Boys, think about it. If you don't hoot, someone could come up and hoot you from behind. I've seen it happen.
Very well. The combination will work like this. Live recite 3 times. Sparta, Troy, Sparta, Troy, Sparta, Troy. After the 3rd time, the winner will be evident. They will ascend to heaven in glory.
What a ride.
While the losers will descend to Oklahoma City in shame.
Bye-bye. All right, we got to win. Sit up straight, Troy. Sit up straight. Support from the diaphragm. If you didn't bring one...
3, 2, 1.
Oh, it doesn't matter. We're Trojans. So, just be loud. Follow me.
Trojans.
Trojans. We will never break. Woo! Trojans. Trojans. We will never break. Woo!
Everybody stand up. Stand up. Show them who we are.
Trojans. Trojans. We will never break. Woo!
We won.
Woo!
Bye-bye, skanky losers. 1, 2, 3.
Bye-bye, skanky losers.
Oh, Billy, Sparta has won.
What?
I can prove it.
Oh, really?
Watch this. Hey, Sparta, who won?
Hey, Troy, who won?
Woo!
Who really won?
Troy, who really won?
Oh, you can when you're stupid.
Troy, are we the best side?
Woo!
Are we gonna allow our precious children to be called the equals of all those smelly donkeys over there?
Woo!
That's how I feel. And I'll tell you this right now. Troy, simply because
I love you. Individually and as a group until my back gives out. I will step forward as your champion.
Bring it.
And I will throw all caution for my own well-being to the wind. Yeah. As I muster the courage and I challenge that little girl with the bow and arrow to a... Hi, sweetheart. She's about this tall.
Billy!
Hey, sweetheart.
Billy!
What?
You said I could be the little girl.
Well, that was last night.
Oh, God.
It was rehearsal. Don't go broke back on us. Very well. I will challenge this thing to a 2 out of 3 competition groveler where it rightfully belongs. Say it with me, Troy. In the mud for Troy!
Her name outside the club.
2 of us are gonna go into that mud, but only one will come out alive, and it won't be me. Yes,
I can live with that.
Okay,
but one thing I cannot tolerate is another competition ending in chaos.
I got an idea.
Oh, I thought it was a bowel movement. What is it?
Why don't we find somebody in this audience?
Someone in this audience.
Who could be fair and impartial?
Someone who's neither here nor there.
Neither this side nor that
neither
side.
Neither here nor yet.
Drop someone like that one right back there.
Let's hear it for our
judge. Help us out.
In there for Judge Petunia.
Petunia! You hardly ever hear it anymore, but that's our second one today.
Whoa, what are the odds, right?
And now, as the very lovely Petunia is escorted by Billy, Billy, VonBilly,
yes,
towards the steps of decision.
The steps of decision.
Where she will then sit upon the throne of judgment.
The throne of judgment.
While sitting underneath the umbrella of truthiness. At this juncture, you may be wondering, will she be a fair and accurate judge? The answer is yes, for it is written, whoever sits up there must always speak the truth. If Petunia were to utter a single lie, her head will explode right over her shoulders. Hell yes, right, Mr. Yeah. All right, are you ready?
And we will begin. As soon as our beautiful, sexy Judge Petunia announces in her deepest,
darkest,
sexiest,
morning after voice,
let the games begin, and then the crowd goes wild.
All right, slap the crowd in. Cue Petunia.
Let the games begin.
Woo! Oh, lovely Petunia, since I accepted the challenge, may I go first?
All right, ladies first.
I was going first anyway. For you, my friends of Sparta, I shall now doff my cape. Remove my neck of feet. Now I will remove a shoe. Now I will remove the other shoe. And now I shall remove articles of clothing. Instead, I will start the torch the pit, where what I will do for you now is internationally acclaimed. The Italians call this Facce de Modamo. The Spanish know it as the dreaded Donde está la biblioteca. Me, I call it Face in the Mud for Sparta! I need a dramatic backwards countdown from 3, ending with Face in the Mud. And 3, 2, 1,
Face in the Mud!
2 eyes, a nose, a mouth, Face in the Mud! Now, for an extra added bonus, Face through the Mud.
Hey!
Hey! Hey!
worse than me.
This thing is far from over.
All right, pal. You won round one.
I know.
What will you do now?
Well, halfway for my second and final event.
Don't get cocky.
I can't help it. It's the cut of my pants. I will prove I am truly a Renaissance man. I shall first do this by taking from the mud pit what we in the business call a blobbo. I will then place this blobbo firmly yet sensitively into the disenfranchised, unemployed, barren wasteland I call the inside of my pants.
But wait, there's more.
For now, I shall take my skilled hands of an artisan, and I will sculpt the mud into an exact likeness of a replica, of a knockoff, of a bust of William Shakespeare that I once saw when it was pretty dark out. But what I need from all my Trojans to inspire me is to chant over and over again, show us Willie.
Show us Willie. Show us Willie. Show us Willie.
I got Shakespeare in my pants for Troy!
What I will do for you now cannot be described!
What?
It can only be witnessed!
Oh no, oh no, 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 no. Oh. Oh, no, 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 no. No, 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 don't, no, no, don't.
Sorry I let you down. Bad knee, bad knee.
For those of you paying attention, you realize we are now tied 1-1. Raise your hand if you saw that coming. Great. We're all on the same page as we move to the rubber match.
Well, all right, Trojans. You know, I am so confident I'm going to win the final event and prove we are the greatest side. I ask you, Troy, want to raise the stakes?
Yeah. Woo!
Raise the stakes.
Okay.
And I decree.
Hold on, pal.
Don't stop an old man mid-decree.
If you get to name the stakes,
yes.
I insist. I get to name the nature of our final event.
Did you say insist?
I did.
Well played, Grasshopper. All right. Whoever wins the final event, not only will they be the greatest beggar from the greatest side, but together with the greatest judge ever. To the nearest beer booth, where the winners and the winners only will. Party, 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 party.
There we go.
Oh. I think Shakespeare needs a facelift. However, there's going to be a losing beggar. And whichever beggar loses, no matter who he or she may be, that loser is going to be forced to mount that platform.
No!
Halfway, it just means stand on it.
Okay.
And in front of everyone, that loser will eat mud. Yeah. Now that's entertainment, Fossy Hands.
Is that copacetic?
It's
you?
Okay.
What do you got?
Oh, I got an idea.
What is it?
Here's the idea for our very last entertainment bit.
Yes, sir.
Each of the beggars will now go out amongst their side, be it Sparta, be it Troy.
I love you.
Whichever beggar can have the most fun.
Oh, we, I can do that.
Make the most new friends.
Hi, everybody.
Learn the hottest dance steps.
I already know this one.
Whoa. I think I sharted.
Did you? Okay. Whichever beggar can return to nothing, Judge Petunia with the hat.
I have hat.
Filled with the most single. Five, ten, 20, and $2 $1 bill.
Interesting.
That nigga will win.
Yes.
The loser will eat mine.
Right.
And remember,
we don't have to be doing this right now. We could be robbing your homes. So stick around. This show ain't over till that beggar eats mud. Let's hear for the best side ever. Swing voters. All right. Here we go. I love you. I love you. Oh, you guys are great. Oh, anybody else? Hold on. Oh, bless you, babe. May I call you, babe? You can call me Steph.
Thank you, my friend. You have it tough. You're right on the borderline. You can smell the drones from here. Hey,
not quite the Broadway class. I love you all. I love you with the love.
Any Trojan traitors? Anybody in Troy want to rethink their whole allegiance?
I'm from Troy.
Boo!
I tried. Ladies and gentlemen.
Oh my God, I got elephantitis. Ladies and gentlemen, before we go any further, state law requires I have to ask this question of both sides. I'm asking both sides. Has everybody on both sides been able to give to the beggar of their choice?
Yes!
Thank you. Is everybody on both sides ready for our grand finale? Brace yourselves. Round two. Here we go. Round two. Now, whoever gets the first dollar.
Round three.
I'm so sorry, no one else is going to get 20, no matter how much.
how many I have. There's 120, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I can't even count. Probably a million.
From the greatest people ever.
That's all, Jim.
And hold up both your arms. You're gonna weigh the hats. When we ask you to pick a winner, pick a winner, but not until we ask. And now, excuse me, I gotta take a Shakespeare. There we go. Oh, that's a weight off my knee. All right, ladies and gentlemen, as beautiful, sexy Judge Petunia becomes the scales of justice, let's all try to encourage her to make the correct choice. We love you, Petunia.
We love you, Petunia. We love you, Petunia. We love you, Petunia. We love you, Petunia.
Petunia.
Love me, Petunia. Hold high.
Hold high the winning hat.
Children.
Come on. Children.
We gotta live with it. Means we come to my very favorite part of the show. I think you'll enjoy this as well. This is the moment when lovely Petunia will do a swan dive into
the Halfwit, we talked about this. Yes, we did. This is the part of the show where we show our gratitude to the lovely judge. We beggars do it by presenting to her with this crappy flower we bought at the Family Dollar Tree General. And you may do it with your heartfelt applause. Let's hear for Petunia!
You have a long way back to a seat, so keep it looking.
Here we go.
What? This is fresh.
How can you tell?
It was ground this morning. I save that for after the half past.
I'm going to catch.
Nice catch.
Yeah, I ought to play for the Texans.
Hey, seriously, somebody should.
Yeah, really. Hey, well then, I will eat the mutt after you've all counted backwards from three and exclaimed,
Inchy Weensy, Mudsy Wudsy, Weensy Weensy, Howsy Wowsy. Everybody, 3, 2, 1.
Itsy weensy, mousy mousy, crazy, whatever.
That's right. Ladies and gentlemen, my partner is Ethan Lowe.
And now, before you go,
and write in your blogs that this was the best darn day at the fair ever.
What's left in your wallets?
Who can tell me what is more disgusting than watching one beggar eat mud?
Two!
Do you people read the same joke books?
I think so.
The direct response is the fact that
you paid money to see it, and we love you for it. Thank you all very much.
Thank you.
Coming up at 2 o'clock on this very stage, we have Ron Deedy, escape artist extraordinaire. Come back and see.